When you're learning any programming language, it is very important to work on projects that can help you build your logics and aptitude. That's why in this video, we will be creating a small project on the game of rock, paper, scissors in Python. So hello everyone and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain and in this video, we will be working on this mini project where we will be creating the game of rock, paper, scissors. So we have been playing this game in the childhood. If you don't know what is rock, paper, scissors, I'll just tell you that with the hand gestures, people do rock, paper, scissors and there are certain rules of this game. So we will be making this game in Python. Let's have a look on how we can do it. To create rock, paper, scissors, let's first write the rules. For that, I'll be using in the print statement, we'll write that if rock versus scissors, in rock versus scissors, rock wins. You can put it inside the triple quotation so that we can write it in multiple lines. And then in paper versus rock, paper wins. And lastly, between scissors versus paper, scissors wins. So these are the winning rules. Now what we need to do is we need to take the input from the user that what they want to choose between rock, paper and scissors. So here we will be writing, we'll be using a print statement. Let's give a space of one line, then write print choose one between rock, paper and scissors. And then we will be taking the input from the user. So that's why I'm creating a variable called as user where we will be taking the input from the user. Here we'll be writing input, enter choice. Let's put it inside the double quotations as well. And also I'll be using dot lower over here so that whatever the user writes, it's converted into a lowercase. So user, and also I would like to leave a space of one line in between. So as of now, let's run and see how does it looks like. So as soon as I run it, scissors versus paper, scissor wins, and choose one between rock, paper, scissors. So enter choice, maybe let's write paper. And then we need to print it as well, right? So let's print it that print users choice is user. We will be separating it with the comma because we have a string and a variable over here. Now also with the rules, I will be writing that winning rules are so that it's clear to us that these are the rules and now we have to start the game. So maybe you can also add, now let's start the game. Okay, so this is how it looks like in the starting. Also, many times it might happen that user may write anything else instead of rock, paper and scissors. Maybe the spelling is not correct. In that case, we can use a loop over here by writing that while user not in. That means if user has not chosen between rock, we'll make sure that we'll keep all the cases in lower and rock, paper and scissors. In that condition, we'll ask the user to print a valid input. So print valid, maybe we can tell them that this is invalid input, and then in the user input again we can ask them to print valid input. So for that we'll be taking the user input again. So user is equals to input. So if they have written any wrong choice, maybe they have written the spelling of scissors wrong, or maybe they have written 1, 2, 3 or any other thing other than rock, paper, scissors, in that case this print statement will be executed. Also, we will ask for the user input again, where we will be writing enter valid choice. And let's put it in the double quotations. So let's run till here. As soon as I'll run it, this is how the output looks like. That winning rules are this. Now let's start the game. Choose one between rock, paper and scissors. Let's say I'll write rock with the wrong spelling. So you can see it says invalid input. And now if I'll write the correct spelling, it tells me that the user's choice is rock. So every time if I write any wrong input, this will give me that enter a valid choice because your input is invalid. So now once we are done with this, let's move ahead and ask for, because we are playing this game between a user and a computer, this game is going to be between the user and the computer. So now we need to take the input from the computer. Now we cannot ask the computer to write it manually, but what we can do, we can use a random module over here. With the help of random module, the computer will choose between rock, paper and scissors. So for that, first of all, we need to import random module. I'll be writing import random. And we have once we have imported random, let's create a variable called as game. And in this, I'll be passing a list of rock, paper and scissors so that computer can choose one between them. And now for the computer, I'll be taking a variable called as computer is equals to random, we'll be using the random module, that random dot choice. It has to choose one between rock, paper, scissors, which is stored inside the game list. And let's print that computer's choice is comma computer. Now let's run and see how the output looks like. So let's write our choice. Let's write rock. So our choice is rock, computer's choice is paper. It's here, user's choice is rock, computer choice is paper, and between rock and paper, paper wins. So we need to show the results now. So only thing that we are left with is the results. So let's write the results in here. For the results, we'll be using conditional statements, that if user is equal to rock, and we'll be using double equals here, and computer is equals to paper. In that condition, print computer wins. Let's write all the condition for the computer to win first. So I'll just copy this again and let's paste it. Or maybe we can do the same thing for the user, but this time we'll just replace the rock with paper and the paper with rock. And this time our user will win. That's why we'll write user for this condition. Similarly, we'll repeat the same procedure, and instead of if, let's use elif. So let's repeat the very same procedure again, that this time if user chooses rock and computer chooses scissors, in that case user wins. And if the vice versa happens, in that case computer wins. For example, I'll be writing scissors. Make sure when you are changing, when you're copy pasting and writing the names of rocks and rock, paper, scissors, just make sure that you are doing it correctly. Elif, the user's choice is scissors and the computer's choice is rock. In that condition, computer wins. Lastly, we need to give the choices between the paper and the scissors. So I'll quickly copy this and paste it. So between paper and scissors, scissors wins. That's why computer wins here. And between scissors and paper, user wins. So make sure you put the correct logic in here. And if anything other than these things, what will happen, that both of them, whatever is the output in both of them is the same. For example, I have also chosen paper and the computer also chooses paper. In that condition, it will be a tie. So lastly, in that condition, we'll print it's a tie. Now let's run it again. And let's write paper. And our choice is paper, computer's choice is also paper, that's why it's a tie. Let's run it again. Our choice is maybe, let's say rock. Our choice is rock, computer's choice is paper. And between rock and paper, paper wins. That's why it shows computer wins over here. Also, what you can add to it is, you can add scores in it as well. And also, you can use a loop in here. So, we'll start with adding scores. So there will be two scores, that user's score is equals to, initially it will be 0, and computer's score will be also 0. But when it will increase? When the computer wins. So when computer wins, computer score increases by 1. So plus is equals to 1. And it happens every time computer wins. So I'll just copy this line of code and write wherever computer wins. So wherever computer wins, we increase the score by 1. Similarly, wherever user wins, we write the same thing, but this time instead of computer, we will be writing user score. So user score plus is equals to 1 every time the user wins. Lastly, you can print these scores, that print user score, by writing user's score is comma user score. Similarly, print computer's score is computer score. So what we have done here is, basically we have created two variables known as user score and computer score. We have increased one score every time any one of them wins, and lastly we have printed it as well. Last thing that we can do over here is, we can add a loop. Where do we need to add a loop is from here, that you need to choose between rock, paper and scissors. So let's use maybe while true. So let's add while true, and let's select everything after while true. Use a tab to shift it inside. Now let's run and see. So as soon as I'll run this program, it will ask me enter choice. Let's write rock. It says ours is rock, computer is also rock. It's a tie, that's why the score is zero right now. Again, let's write paper maybe. So, we have written paper, the computer chooses rock. Between paper and rock, paper wins. That's why the user's score is one. Again, it's asking for the choice. So, let's write scissors. And it's a tie, that's why nobody got a score. Let's write rock. And because this time the computer wins, that's why the computer score is increased by one. So you can keep doing it, or you can also break the loop by giving a repeat statement over here. So that will just add like two more lines in the end, that repeat is equals to, let's take the input from the user, that input, do you want to play again. So because if we want to play again, if the user says no, so for that, if I'll write if repeat equals no, also we'll do one thing, let's take the input in the lowercase only. So if the repeat is equal to small n o no, in that condition let's break the loop. And you can see also, what we can also do is, we can write a print statement, an empty print statement to give a space of one line. And here we are done with almost 50 lines of code. Within almost 50 lines of code and maybe less, we have created a game of rock, paper, scissors. And I'll just run this game again for you. So, enter choice, rock. And it's a tie. Do you want to play again? Yes. Again, I'll choose rock. Again, it's a tie. And again, I want to play. And that's why again I'll write rock. And this time I got a score of 1. And do you want to play again? Let's say no. And it will end the code over here. So guys, this is how easily with less than 50 lines of code we have created this game. Although it says the count is 52 over here. But you can also see that we have some empty lines in here. That's why we can say that in less than 50 lines of code we have created this game. I hope you guys have no doubts and no questions on how we have created this game. This game was very simple to create. We only had to use the random module, some variables, loops and conditional statements, and our game was ready. So I hope you guys like this video, and if you like this video, do like, share and subscribe. And for more such content, stay tuned guys. Thank you.